Welcome back to the ITU headquarters here in Geneva, which is of course hosting the AI for Good Global Summit. This is of course the first day, and I'm joined now by the lady who's just given her presentation in front of the 500 delegates. It's Francesca Rossi, and she's of course a research scientist at IBM. Thanks, Francesca, for being here.
Thank you.
So, I mean, IBM goes back a long way with AI. Why have you come here? Because presumably you already know everything.
Well, I mean, I've been working in AI, you know, all my career, and it's true, IBM has a long history of tackling big challenges within AI and achieving really great results, and now is completely revolutionizing the whole company based on cognitive computing and AI technology. But I think that, you know, the goal of this initiative, this event, is that now we are at the point where AI has so much potential, as well as some limitations, of course, that there are also challenges, not just technological challenges, but also challenges in understanding how to guide the AI development in the best way, you know, following the best path so that AI is beneficial for everybody and not just for a few people. And can be used for really, you know, social good, for the benefit of people, societies. And the only way that we can understand how to do that is in a very multidisciplinary environment, discussion with all the stakeholders, NGOs, corporate people, scientific associations, academia, everybody, policymakers, governments, and so on. Because only by talking all together, we can understand how to really move forward. So one initiative that I belong to many initiatives, but I think that this one that puts together, you know, UN, ITU, and other of these organizations together with academic and corporate people developing AI, I think has a lot of potential in delivering concrete next steps for the beneficial use of AI.
Next steps. And what is next steps?
Well, there may be many. So, of course, there has been already some initiative that has spelled out some principles for beneficial development of AI. Some one way would be to think about best practices or educational efforts in educating policymakers, governments about AI and AI ethics and the implication of AI, so that regulations also can come at the right time and with the right strength, not too little, not too much. And I think that there is a role in really networking among all the stakeholders. So, for example, I represent IBM within the Partnership on AI, which is another initiative that puts together corporate and non-corporate entities that wants to, again, discuss whatever issue there is in the deployment of AI and solve it all together in a collaborative environment. And so this initiative that we are having today and tomorrow and the next 3 days is really instrumental in bringing also the sustainability goals into the picture of what it would mean to develop AI for the benefit of everybody. Because I think that AI has a lot of potential to improve our life, meaning the life of people living in a first world country, but much more potential to really improving the life of people in the developing country.
The other question, though, of course, is that IBM would have access, or people like them, to a lot of big data. And how does that privacy get respected?
Yeah, so IBM just released a few months ago his own principles, commitments to dealing with this data in the most transparent way. You know, so we are going to, first of all, we are going to develop AI only to augment human intelligence and not replacing it. Second, we are going to really want to be transparent and trustworthy in the way we use the data of our clients. And so that people know when we use AI on their data and what we do with that data. So data privacy and data issues in general, data ownership, data storage is very important for IBM. And IBM has a long history, even besides AI, has a long history of really caring about these values, and we want to bring that history also in developing AI with the right kind of values into the picture, also about data privacy and data issues in general.
Francesca Rossi of IBM, thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.